I had terrible trouble getting the meme machine published. My agent sent it to all, you know, half a dozen of her sort of top choice publishers. No, all these rejection letters. Oh, it's a rubbish idea. It was too speculative for us. I mean, all sorts of, you know, reasons why they didn't want it. And she simply said to me, no good, try something else. And I was like, no, I mean, this is my, you know, this is my great, as far as I'm concerned, I felt that I would never have good ideas like that again. I mean, they may be mad, they may be wrong, but here was a whole bunch of coherent ideas that gives you a really different view on human nature and our origins and what we are and consciousness and all sorts of things. And nobody wants it. So I got quite depressed about it, but there was no way I was going to give up the idea. And one day I met Richard Dawkins at the most extraordinary event. The Daily Mail, somebody from the Daily Mail rang me up and said, oh, we're doing a picture of scientists and we want you in it. I was like, what do you mean you're doing a picture of scientists? We do a picture every week. And I gathered that they would do, you know, interior designers one week and, I don't know, architects the next week and, you know, shop assistants, I don't know, whatever, pop stars the next week. And they were doing scientists. You know, they were not doing chemists or psychologists or, you know, but scientists. So I said, no way, I'm not going to London to have my picture taken. You know, what do you think I am? But when she announced who all the other people in the picture were going to be, Richard Dawkins, Colin Blakemore, Susan Greenfield, all sorts of interesting people going to be in this this picture, I thought, all right, I'll go. Vanity. So off I go to London. And then Richard Dawkins and I are standing, leaning against the wall while they're fiddling around with all their lights and so on and so on. And he said, oh, you know, how are things going with your book? Because I'd mentioned it to him before and he'd seen just a very brief synopsis of it. And I said, terrible, you know, nobody wants it and everyone thinks it's a stupid idea, you know. And he said very diffidently, I mean, you know, he's not known for being diffident, but he said very diffidently, he said, well, I don't know if it would help. And you please say if you don't want me to, but, you know, I'd be very happy to write a foreword for you. And I was like, ah, wow, you know, yes, of course, yes, please. You know, I'd only met him a few times. I didn't know him that well. But, I mean, there were two things. One, it was so wonderful that clearly he thought my ideas were good enough that he was prepared to do that. And secondly, of course, what then happened, he put me in touch with an editor at Oxford University Press who liked the ideas. I got on with him very well, and it went from there, and I was able to write it. But I still think, you know, if it hadn't been for just bumping into him then, would I have given up? No, I'd have done it somehow, but it would have been very difficult.